Inumaki Toge, a student in Jujutsu High School in Jujutsu Kaisen World. Toge is a second year at Tokyo Jujutsu High along with Yuta, Maki and Panda. He is a descendant of Inumaki family who inherited the rare and powerful curse speech technique. As a member of the Inumaki family, Toge is a respected semi-grade 1 sorceress. Next to Aoi Todo, Toge is considered to be among the strongest and the most respected Jujutsu student outside of Yuta and Hakari. His curse technique and athletic abilities have earned him a strong reputation among the students, and even Getto believed that he was a sorceress blessed with great potential. Toge is highly intelligent with high stamina, as well as an expert understanding of how to wield his powerful curse technique. Alongside stamina, curse speech requires a high degree of cursed energy, especially if Toge faces off against a powerful curse. His ability can spread over a wide range and affect all curses weaker than him without fail. His very presence on the battlefield makes it difficult for anyone against him to focus due to the nature of his technique. While overusing his ability creates a backlash to his body, Toge can still unleash attacks capable of affecting special grade curses as well. Curse speech is a powerful curse technique without any doubt. This technique has many advantages, and one of the advantages is it can work on very large distance. Inumaki can even use it over a phone as he did against Miwa in the school event. And of course, with strong powers, he also has some weaknesses just like everyone else does. Except Gojo, of course. Even though Inumaki can command anyone to do anything he wants, the stronger the command he gives to his opponent, the more cursed energy is used. And because of excess use of cursed energy in case of a strong command, it affects the Inumaki's physical body. These effects include sore throat, inability to speak. Inability to speak is the most dangerous one because he won't be able to use the technique for a while because of this. For this reason, Inumaki always had to carry a cough syrup bottle with him. But these effects are not just that simple. Inumaki also has a limit beyond which he cannot use his cursed energy. If he tries to surpass his limits, then it damages his whole body on a much greater scale. As we all have seen what happened when he used blast away word against Hanami. Thus, he has to be very careful with the intensity of the powers he is using. Because of this ability, whatever he says comes true because of his curse speech technique. It is literally what it sounds like. Curse speech technique. It is a curse for him as well as for his friends if it is used in a wrong way. To stop that, he never says what he wants to say. Instead, he uses code or safe words. Like this. All the words he uses are called the part of the Onigiri language. Onigiri is not actually a language, but Onigiri means rice ball, which is a Japanese dish. He uses all of the ingredients used in creating Onigiri as a part of his daily conversation. People around him are kind of used to it now and easily understands what he wants to say. Let's take a look at what this Onigiri language means. First, the word he often uses is sake. Sake sushi are salmons in English. They indicate Inumaki's agreement or affirmation of something. Okaka. Okaka means bonito flakes or fish flakes. Okaka is the opposite of sake and sake sushi. It implies Inumaki's disagreement or a denial. Kombu. Kombu is kelp. That means it is kind of a Inumaki's greeting to a new person. Takana. It literally translates as a pickled mustard leaf. It indicates concern and worry. Next is Sujiko and Ikura or Igura. Sujiko means salted pepper in English and Ikura means how much. However, they mean totally different in Inumaki's Onigiri language. Sujiko is used to grab other person's attention and means something like, hey, look at me, look at here, look at this. And on the other hand, if Inumaki says Ikura or Igura to you, he is swearing at you. Lastly, Tuna Tuna. Tuna Tuna is Inumaki's urging to person to look, and Tuna Mayo is him urging a person to talk. Incidentally, Tuna Mayo is also Inumaki's favorite Onigiri ingredient. So, now we know what Inumaki means when he talks in Onigiri. I got all of this information from Twitter. Just to be clear that I am not a specialist in this Onigiri language. So, I think that summed up about the video of Onigiri language and Inumaki Toge's curse technique. What are your thoughts about this video? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed this video, just don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Because I post daily anime content about top 10 top 5 listings, anime reviews, recommendations, news, theories and all sort of anime content on daily basis. So if you enjoyed, please subscribe, and that was it. And I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.